Thank you. This is the day the Lord has made. Hallelujah. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. Hallelujah. We give you all the praise, God. Hallelujah. We love to call your name. It's something we cannot explain that happens when we proclaim your great name. Your great name we love.
We love to
call your name.
Call your name.
It's something we cannot explain.
We cannot explain
that happens.
When we proclaim
Your great King Jesus.
Hey, no other name, King Jesus,
not stronger
when we call on.
Things change
when we call on your
name. Come on, lift those hands right there,
King Jesus. No.
Stronger
when we call on.
Things change.
Hallelujah. When we call on your name.
Hallelujah.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Power in your name.
Hallelujah.
There is power in the name of Jesus. Power in your name.
Come on, say, there is power
in the name of.
Come on, sing it with us. Power in his name.
Power in his name.
Yes, Lord. There is power
in the name of Jesus.
Power in your name.
Power in your name.
Hallelujah.
Things change when we call you, Jesus.
Things change
when we call
you. Yes, it does. When you begin to call his name, everything has to change. Hallelujah. Things are not the same. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Come on, just lift those hands and worship him, for you are never defeated. Hallelujah. You have the victory.
Hallelujah.
Come on, just begin to praise him. We honor your name, God. Come on, just begin to worship him where you are. We praise you, oh God, for we are never defeated. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We have the victory. You are victorious. Hallelujah. We glorify you. We praise you, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. I will say that again. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. Come on, sing with me. And because God is the greatest power,
is the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated,
never be defeated.
And because God,
and because God
is the greatest power,
is the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated,
never be defeated.
Come on, just lift those hands and worship him right there, for you are never defeated. Hallelujah. We honor your name, God. We glorify you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We worship you. We glorify you. Come on, say, I shall rise.
I shall.
I shall be.
I shall be.
I shall go.
I shall go
in victory.
In victory.
No weapon formed.
No weapon formed
against me.
Against me.
Will never,
will never
overtake me.
Overtake me.
And because God,
and because God
is the greatest power,
the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
And because God,
and because God
is the greatest power,
the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated,
never be defeated.
And because God,
and because God
is the greatest power,
the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated,
never be defeated.
And because God,
and because God
is the greatest power,
the greatest power,
we shall never,
never
be defeated,
never be defeated.
Come on, just lift those hands and worship him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The devil is a liar.
Yes.
God is exalted.
Yes, Lord.
Never be defeated. Never be defeated.
Come on, join and say,
the devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Yes, Lord.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
God is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Now come on, just begin to worship him.
Hallelujah.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Even when I feel defeated,
never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Yes,
Lord.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar. The
devil is a liar.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Now come on, begin to praise him right there.
Never be defeated.
For you shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Come on, the devil is a liar. Hallelujah.
Never be defeated.
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 Never, never.
Never be defeated.
Come on, begin to praise him right now. Never be defeated. Come on, just say it. Come on, be declared right now that you shall never be defeated. Hallelujah. Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
Never be defeated.
He keeps on lying.
Never be defeated.
When he said I'm sick,
never be defeated.
God says I'm healed.
Never be defeated.
When he said I'll lose,
never be defeated.
God said I'll win.
Never be defeated.
He said I'll die.
Never be
but God said I'll live. Hey, the devil is a liar.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
Never
come on, say it. The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
Don't believe he says, don't believe nothing you hear.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
Hey, he's the father of lies.
The devil is a liar.
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 Now come on, you got the victory right there. The devil is a liar. Come on, shout out there because you have the victory. Yes, Lord, we worship you. Come on, begin to magnify.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Woo!
Oh, hallelujah.
Come on, let's sing. Begin to worship him out there.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
Hey. The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
The devil is a liar.
The devil is a liar.
God is exalted.
God is exalted.
Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
I shall never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Come on, begin to worship him. Come on, shout right there in your house. Because you shall never be defeated. Never, never.
Thank you.
Never, never. Never be defeated. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. Come on, say.
And because God
is the greatest power,
is the greatest power,
we shall never,
we shall never,
we shall never,
never be defeated.
We shall never,
we shall never,
we shall never,
we shall never,
I shall never,
I shall never,
come on, make it personal, I shall never,
I shall never,
I shall never,
I shall never.
shall never. Come on, make it personal. I shall never.
I shall never.
I shall never. Come on, worship Him. I shall never.
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 Never be defeated.
Never be defeated.
Come on, bless the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We worship You.
Hallelujah.
For we shall never be defeated.
Hallelujah.
We glorify Hallelujah. You, God, and we honor Your name. Hallelujah.
You,
we praise You, oh God. Jesus. We are never defeated. How many can say out there, I am never defeated? Come on, just begin to type it on the screen. I am never defeated. We worship You, oh God, for You know our name. We praise You, oh God. We honor Your name,
yes,
Jesus.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
Come on, just worship Him right where you are. Hallelujah. We praise You, oh God. You're worthy. Thank You, Jesus. Hallelujah. We glorify You, Jesus. Hallelujah.
He knows my name.
Yes, He does. Yes, He does.
Thank You, Lord.
He knows my name.
Thank You, Jesus.
He knows my name.
Hallelujah. I'll make this personal.
You know my name.
Hallelujah.
And oh, how He walks with me.
Thank You, Jesus.
And oh, how He talks with me. And oh, how He tells me.
Thank You, Lord.
That I am His own.
Thank You, Lord.
You know my name.
Hallelujah.
You know my name.
Lord, we worship You.
You know my name.
Thank You, Father.
You know my name.
We honor You, Jesus.
And oh, how You comfort me.
Thank You, Jesus.
And oh, how You counsel me. It still amazes me.
Thank You, Lord.
That I am Your friend.
Come on, lift those hands. Hallelujah. We worship You.
So now I pour out my heart to You.
Thank You, Jesus. We worship You.
Here in Your presence, I am made new.
Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus.
So now I pour out my heart to You.
Hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus.
Here in Your presence, I am made new.
Come on, sing with me.
'Cause You know my name.
Come on, let's worship Him. If you know it, sing it out there.
You know my name.
Come on, all over the world, lift your voice. Hallelujah.
You know my name.
Yes, Lord. You know our name, God.
You know my name.
Come on, say, oh, how You walk with me.
Oh, how He walks with me.
Oh, how He talks.
Oh, how He talks with me.
Oh, how He tells me.
Oh, how He tells me.
That I am Your own.
that I am your own.
Come on, worship him all over the world. Hey, I am your own. How many know no fire can burn me? We worship you, oh God. Hallelujah. We glorify you.
Hallelujah.
We honor your name. Hallelujah. Hey, no fire can burn me. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me. Cause you hold my hand and now I'm walking in victory. Cause your power is within me. No giant can defeat me. Cause you hold my hand and no fire can burn me. No battle can turn me. No mountain can stop me. Cause you hold my hand. Now I'm walking in victory. Cause your power, thank you, is within me. No giant can defeat me. Cause you hold my hand. Come on, say no fire.
No fire
can burn me.
Can burn me.
No battle.
No battle
can turn me.
Can turn me.
No mountain.
No mountain
can stop me.
Can stop me.
Cause you
hold. Cause you hold my hand.
Now walking. Now I'm walking.
Your victory,
cause
your power
is within me.
Is within me.
No giant,
no giant
can defeat me.
Can defeat
cause
me.
Cause you hold my hand. Now come on out there, just begin to lift those hands and begin to worship him.
Hallelujah.
Come on, cause God hold our hands. Hallelujah. Come on, begin to lift up a worship right there in your house.
Hallelujah.
Come on, worship him. Worship him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Cause you hold my hand. Thank you, Lord.
You
hold my hand.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You hold my hand. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
You hold my hand. Come on, just stay right there. You hold my hand. You hold my hand.
You hold my hand.
You hold my hand. Thank you.
You
said you'll never leave me, not forsake me. Yes, Lord. You hold.
You
my
hold my hand.
Thank you for being right there,
you
God. Thank you.
My hand.
Thank you for being right there,
you
God.
Hold my hand.
You hold my
you
hand.
Hold my
now come
hand.
On for the next few seconds. Just begin to worship him.
Hallelujah.
Come on, that sit all over the world, sitting right there in your house. Come on, lift your voice. Get lost in worship. For the Lord is with you. He holds your hand. Hallelujah. Come on, worship him.
Hallelujah.
We glorify you. Thank you. We glorify you. Cause you hold our hand,
Lord.
Yes, Lord. You hold our hand. When we feel lonely, God, you're there. When we feel lonely, God, you're there. When we feel lonely, God, you're there. Thank you. When we feel lonely, God, you're there. Come on, cause you hold my hand.
You hold my hand.
Thank you.
You
hold
my hand.
You hold my hand. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. Come on, that's it. Just worship him. This is your opportunity. This is your time to worship him. Yes, Lord, you hold my hand. Now come on, just begin to get lost in worship.
Yes, Lord.
All over the world, come on.
Yes, Lord.
That's it. Minister to your King. Hey. Minister to your God.
Thank you, God.
We glorify you, Lord Jesus.
Jesus.
Hey, God.
God, we thank you.
We glorify you. We glorify you. Come on, just begin to shift the atmosphere right there in your house. Come on, don't just sit and watch us. Open your mouth right where you are in that bedroom. Come on, the presence of the Lord is there. Come on, he's right there. Come on, whatever you need, sitting there. Lift those hands and open your mouth and worship him. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, worship him. Come on, whatever you need. need right now, you can get it sitting there, right there, right there, right there, my brother, right there, my sister. Come on, lift up a praise in your house. Lift up a worship in your house. Lift up a scream in that house. We honor you now, God. Thank you, Lord. Woo. We thank you for your presence even now, God. We thank you for your presence even now. Touch every home. Touch every person that's watching even now. Whatever need that your people may have, oh God, meet every need right now. Meet every need right now. Those who may be sick in their body, oh God. Lord, we know that you're Jehovah Rapha, the healer. Oh God, heal their bodies right now. Those who may be burdened, oh God, lift the burden, oh God. Those who may be worried right now, oh God. Hallelujah. Turn their worriness to gladness and happiness, God. We honor your name. Come on, just begin to worship him. Hallelujah. Everything that is not like God that may be in your house, when you begin to open your mouth and when you begin to worship him, things gotta flee. Hallelujah. Things have to go. Stress have to go. Depression have to go. Sickness have to go. Come on, begin to open your mouth and worship him. Worship, ya Rabba Koshane, ya Dia Rabba Dia Daman Soya. We worship you, God. Woo, hallelujah. We worship you, ya Rabba Koshane, ya Dia Nana Mama Mama Shado Rabade, ya Dia Rabba Dokosha, ya Kia Nana Mama 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 Mane. We glorify you. Woo. Come on, open your mouth. The heavens are open. Come on, the heavens is open right over your house. Come on, lift up a praise. Lift up a worship. Worship him. Come on, make your voice known in the atmosphere. Hallelujah. 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 But you know our name. You know our name. Yeah. Yeah, your name. You know our name, God. We your children cry out unto you today. We your children cry out unto you today. We worship you. Woo, God, I thank you. Thank you, Lord. Moving the airwaves even now. Moving the airways even now. Let your people feel your presence even now. Let your people feel your power. Let them feel your presence. Yeah, God, we glorify you. Hey, we honor you. Yarabando soya. Yarabania na matsi. Yarabando soya na mama mande. Touch their hearts, God. Touch their minds, God. Hallelujah. Restore right now. Restore right now, God. Yarabania na matsho. Those who may have strayed away, God. Lord, begin to tug on their hearts. Begin to pull on their hearts. Draw them back to you, God. Draw them back to you, God. Draw them back to you. Ya Rabando so. Ya Mandi. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God, everybody. How you doing out there this morning? What a wonderful praise and worship that we had here. And I know you enjoyed it as well. But it's oftentimes here at JP Life CC. And oftentimes it's always an exciting time because it's a time that we can sow seeds into the kingdom of God. And so we provided several ways that you can be able to do that. And first of all, you can download the EasyTide app. Download the EasyTide app on your phone, Android phone or iPhone, whatever type of phone you might have. Put in two words, EasyTide. Look for the church logo, the logo that has an E in it, look like a church, and you'll have the right app as you download that app. You also can use the text to give. Put in the word give in the message column. And then you have the number that you see on the screen there. Make sure you put that number in. And in doing that, you can send off a message like you usually send off a message or text to anybody. So that's a text to give. And then you can use the Cash App. The Cash App is just simply, you know, $JPLifeCC. Again, it's $JPLifeCC. And then if you do that, then of course we will receive that offering as well. You can always bring it by the office, either you can mail it in, 800 Northwest 39th Avenue, Gainesville, Florida, Jesus People Life Changing Church, 800 Northwest 39th Avenue, Gainesville, Florida, or you can bring it by the office, if you would please. And in doing that, you just make sure that you call, let us know that you're going to be dropping off an offering or a tithe, and we'll make sure that we are looking out for you as you are going to come by. Praise God. And so we thank God for that. God is good all the time. We'll be back with you in just a minute. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're glad to be with you this morning. We're going to continue our teaching that we talked about and started on last week. Fight, fight, and fight some more. And I tell you, we're in a fight, aren't we? But we're not losing the battle. Our subtopic this morning is fight through the forces attacking our mind. Fight through the forces attacking our mind. And I tell you, one of the things that I've known over the years, and that you're going to have thoughts that's going to come. And you have to kind of like discern those thoughts, whether they are thoughts that God is bringing you or whether they are thoughts that are being projected by another force. And we have these thoughts come in many, many, in various ways. And sometimes they come as a result of us being in a particular atmosphere. Are we hearing something? Or perhaps there are some individuals that we are around, and we hear them say something, and we have thoughts that would come as a result of that, that perhaps we would not have had if we had not been in the company of those individuals. And so we have to be careful about how we allow these particular things to happen in our lives. We have to protect what goes in our, what we think, how we think. We have to protect that and guard it at all times. The enemy always wants to come in and project a thought to you that is not of God. And so we're going to start here in Matthew, the 16th chapter, at verse 21. Where it says, and Jesus began telling his disciples what would happen to him. He said, I must go to Jerusalem. There the nation leaders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law of Moses would make me suffer terribly. I would be killed, but three days later I will rise to life. Notice what happened. Peter took Jesus aside and told him, stop talking like that. God would never let this happen to you, Lord. Jesus turned to Peter and said, Satan, wait a minute. I can imagine what Peter was thinking in his mind. He calling me Satan. He's talking to me. The one that just got the revelation that he was the son of God. The one that said, you are the son of God. And he said, flesh and blood has not revealed it to you, but my Father who is in heaven. And Jesus, he said, Satan, get away from me. You are in the way because you think like everyone else and not like God. You think like everyone else and not like God. So people that are saying things contrary to the word of God, contrary to what you're believing, you have to literally broke them. Now, I don't advise you to call them a devil, but you might want to say, wait a minute. That's not what the word of God says. The word of God says, I am healed. The word of God says, all my needs are met. The word of God says, I can have what I say. So what you're saying versus what the word of God says, I refuse to receive that. Now, you can easily say that, and you know, but we have to realize that there are certain things that we have to confront. We have to confront these particular situations because they are coming through demonic forces, and the spirit of the enemy is using these individuals. Now, the Bible has a lot to say about the mind and how it works, the traits and the characteristics of the mind. And I want you to know something. You know, it talks about in 1 Chronicles, the 28th chapter, verses 9 and 10, someone having a willing mind. A willing mind is a mind to please God, to do God's will, to associate with the thoughts of the Lord. That's a willing mind. Boy, that's the one that we all want to have, a willing mind. And then, of course, it's a mind to work. In Nehemiah, if you will, the fourth chapter, a mind that does what's necessary to get the job done, a mind to work. Well, that's one that we all want to have. But this is one we don't want to have. We don't want to have a wicked mind. That's found in Proverbs 21st chapter and verse 20, 27. This mind is deceitful. It has deceitful intentions. That's a wicked mind. You know how people just think evil. They think they plan on doing things that God has not required us to do. And so they go totally against the word of God. But we don't want to have that type of mind. This is another one you don't want to have. You don't want to have a double mind. A double mind that's found in Luke, the 12th chapter, verses 28 to 31. It is a mind that worries about the necessities of life. You don't want to be concerned about the necessities of life. Jesus said it so clearly in the scripture. Your Father knows that you have needed these things. What are those things, Pastor Mingo? What you need to eat, what you need to drink, and what you need to wear. He already knows, so he don't want us to be worried. But you want to have a readiness of mind. It's a mind that's open to receive. It is an open-minded person, Acts the 17th chapter and verse 11. Then, this one you don't want to have, a reprobated mind. A reprobated mind is a mind that is depraved, a mind that rejects God, a mind which is determined to do what it wants, not what God wants, in Romans the first chapter, verses 28 to 32. Then there's a spiritual mind. Well, we want that one, don't we? A spiritual mind is a mind that obeys the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Producing life. Romans the 8th chapter, verses 1 to verse 7. Then the carnal mind. We definitely don't want that one. A carnal mind is a mind that obeys the appetites of the natural man. Romans the 8th chapter, verse 4. Then the lowliness of mind. A lowliness of mind is a mind of humility. Philippians the 2nd chapter, verses 2 to verse 5. Then you have the sober-minded. Boy, we want to have a sober-minded. Be sober-minded because that's a mind that is serious. That's a person who thinks on the serious side of things. Then, of course, As we mentioned before in James, the first chapter, verse 8, talk about the double-minded man that's unstable in all of his ways. And so we don't want this. Our mind is vital to the overall development of our life, of our spiritual growth. If we're going to grow spiritually, we have to guard what goes in our mind, because that is exactly what filters into our spirit. The spirit has, the Bible talks about this and how we have to be renewed in our mind. Once we get born again, we got to be renewed in our mind. Paul encourages us to let us have the same mind which was in Christ Jesus. He tells us that in Philippians, the second chapter, in verse 5. When we are born again, brothers, our mind automatically, from that moment, our minds, once we are born again, is under the stewardship of the Holy Spirit to be acclimated to God's will, to God's way of thinking. That's what our mind is being changed, if we allow it to be changed. Holy Spirit is constantly highlighting the negative aspects of our mind that are ineffective to fulfilling God's will. He is reversing our way of thinking each and every day with a spiritual perspective that will have the mind of God. I want you to listen to this here in 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, in verse 14. It says it like this here. The man without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God, but they are foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them, because they are spiritually discerned. Notice how it says they are spiritually discerned. In other words, you can't discern it unless you have Holy Spirit. The spiritual man makes judgment about all things, but he himself is not subject to any man's judgment. Listen to verse 16. For he who knows the mind of the Lord, that he makes instructions, but we have the mind of Christ. I want you to put that in your comments. I have the mind of Christ. I have the mind of Christ. And you need to wake up in the morning and say, I have the mind of Christ. See, it is with a positive spiritual perspective, we are more likely to be forward-thinking individuals. What is a forward-thinking? This type of forward-thinking expects good things. Forward-thinking individual, you're expecting good things. Come on, say it out of your mouth. I'm expecting good things. I'm expecting good things to happen because my mind is reinforcing the attitude of what I should think as it pertains in Philippians, the fourth chapter. Paul tells us in verse 8, he said, finally, brothers, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. He says in verse 9, whatever you have learned or received from me and seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. So if I think the right thing, the God of peace is going to be with me. He's going to be with me. See, we got to think the right thing. Amen. Praise God. Because that's what God is requiring of us, that we think the right thing. And when you do that, hallelujah, you'll have exactly what God will have you have. See, if we are to be mature spiritually, it will be determined by our ability to learn to appropriate God's word in our inner spirit. I have to appropriate God's word in my inner spirit. In other words, I have to make it a part of what I do on a day-to-day basis. Not when it's convenient, but you have to do that when it's not convenient. You have to do that even when you don't feel like doing it. You have to make sure that you have the word of God, because it's through the application of the word. The application of the word will become the foundation which anchors us to steadiness and a firmness of mind. That's how I know when people are solid, when they're not wavering, when they're not pulled off because something happened. Something goes on with the children, now you don't want to come to church. Something going on with the husband, now you don't want to pray no more. Something going on in the job, now when you come, people see you're all sad and doomed. No, steadiness. A firmness of mind that no matter what's going on, you're going to remain focus. You're going to remain steady in your faith. See, the scripture teaches us that having a mind that ruled by the Holy Spirit gives us life and peace. Ruled by the Holy Spirit. He tells us that in Romans, the 8th chapter. People who are ruled by their desires think only of themselves. Everyone who rules by the Holy Spirit thinks about spiritual things. Are you ruled by the Holy Spirit? Are you thinking spiritual things? Do sometimes, instead of just watching, you know, those the secular things on TV, that you do put on the Word and let the Word, you know, that's being taught and preached all over the world. Do you take time to listen to the Word? Do you take time to open up your phone? We have our phone. We look at Facebook. What about taking time, you know, and looking at all the social networks? What about taking the time of just hitting that Bible app and letting the scripture just speak to you? The Word of God is the power unto salvation. See, if our minds are ruled by our desires, we will die. We will die. But if our minds are ruled by the Spirit, we will have life and peace. Come on, tell somebody next to you, I want life and peace. And if you're going to have life and peace, your mind got to be ruled by the Spirit of God. You got to be ruled by the Spirit of God. See, our desires fight against God. Those things that, you know, those fleshly desires and those things, because they cannot and they do not and cannot obey God's law. But if we follow our desires, we cannot please God. Praise God. Praise God. If you follow your desires, you can't please God. And so Satan, he's weighing heavily on having access to our mind, especially those who want to benefit themselves. He wants access to your mind. You know, you just want to please yourself. You just want to please yourself. That's all you want to do. No. Tell somebody, I'm not one that just want to please myself. I want to please God. If we are guarding our thoughts from the attacks to our mind, we will find ourselves under Satan's control. That's exactly what's going to happen. And some people are under Satan's control. They're under Satan's control. And 1 Peter, the Bible tells us in verse 5, in chapter 5, verses 9, be controlled, be self-controlled, and alert. Uh-oh. Your enemy, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion looking for someone to devour. The devil is looking for somebody that he can resist. But the scripture says in verse 9, resist him. Stand firm in the faith. Resist him. Praise God. He's going to come. And he's not just coming to you. He's coming to everyone. He's coming to people throughout the world. All over the world, he's coming. See, with the same thing. See, Satan's objective. He has an objective. An objective. Praise God. And you know what that is? To get us to the point of giving up. He wants you to give up. He don't want you to make a stand, because he knows that you start making a stand, what's going to happen? You're going to get stronger. If you keep lifting no weights, guess what? You're going to keep getting stronger. Amen. And when you get stronger, guess what? He can't do anything with you. See, he can't stop what God's will in your life. When you are standing firm up against him. See, we fight through his attacks. By resisting those thoughts he projects to our mind. We fight them. Every time you resist the thoughts. And so then we can replace our thoughts with God's word. The Bible tells us in Joshua the 1:1-8. He says, do not let the book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it, Mingo. How much, Father? Day and night. Why? So that you can be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. So success comes as a result of the word of God being applied to my life. Success comes as a result of taking that word and internalizing that word on the inside of me. So when the enemy says something, I can be like Jesus, who was tempted in the wilderness. It is written. And see, if you don't have the word inside of you, you don't know how to fight. You don't have no weaponry to fight him with, because you fight with the word of God. The word of God is how you fight. Satan desires to have us under his influence. That's what he wants. He's looking for ways to infiltrate us mentally and emotionally. He's trying to find ways. He's trying to push buttons to get you upset. He's trying to do things through people to get you emotionally, aroused, if you will. That's what he's trying to do. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, say, but don't let him. Don't let him. Don't let him. Don't let him do that. He will pressure us at certain entry points internally and externally. That's what it does with thoughts contrary to what's right. Oh, they don't like you. They don't care anything about you. See, if your husband really, really loved you, he wouldn't have said that to you like that. He wouldn't have did what he did. If your wife really cared about you, she would have supported you. Oh, no, you need to get somebody, be with somebody that's going to support you. That's what the devil does. John, the 12th chapter, verses 2 to verse 6. Here a dinner was given. A dinner was given in Jesus' honor. And Martha served, you know, when Lazarus, after he had been raised from the dead, and they were reclining at the table. And Martha took a pint of pure perfume, and expensive perfume, and she poured it on Jesus' feet and wiped his feet with her hair. And the house was filled with the fragrance. And somebody said, one of the disciples, Judas Iscariot, you know what he said? Who was the one that portrayed? He said, why wasn't this perfume sold and money given to the poor? It was worth a year wages. He didn't say that because he cared about the poor. He said it because he was a thief. He was taking money. And he says, my goodness, now some of the money that I could have had a whole year wages, I could have got at least a fourth of that, you know. And so from that moment on, the Bible says that the devil entered into Jesus. He says, I'm not getting nowhere with this. This man, Jesus, I'm not getting nowhere. I might as well just, you know, see if I can get some money from the Pharisees and the scribes. Because the enemy put that thought in his mind. I wonder how long the devil had been probing his mind with that thought. You know, while he was stealing money. See, he was already stealing stuff. And that's not like the Lord didn't know it. You know, but God sometimes allow us to do things in hope that we would repent. And hope that we would do the right thing. And that's what he did with Judas. Don't let it be so with you. Praise God. Don't continue doing the wrong thing and then make excuses of why you're doing the wrong things. Oh, no. See, our mind under the Holy Spirit influence is the greatest spiritual asset that we have. It's the greatest. And when we're under the influence of Holy Spirit, we literally transform. We literally transform our perception on how to fight the attacks to our mind. The Holy Spirit will tell you. The scripture tells us in 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, eyes have not seen, nor ears has heard, nor mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. But God revealed it to us by his Spirit. Watch this, because the Spirit searches all things, even the deep things of God. Holy Spirit will show you and reveal to you how to fight that your enemies. He will give you the victory where you can be triumphant. See, right influences can cause the spirit of our mind to have a spiritual envision to fulfill God's will. And that's what we want. We want to have a vision to fulfill God's will. So how do we fight through the forces attacking our mind? We learn submission, number one. We learn application, number two. And then we have faith in God's word, number three. It's easier for us to make the right decisions when we have these things working in our lives. The Bible tells us in Proverbs, the 4th chapter, verse 20, my son, pay attention to what I say. Listen closely to my words. Do not let them out of your sight. Keep them within your heart, for they are life. What? The word of God to those who find them, and health to the man's whole body. Above all, watch this now, guard your heart, Mingo. guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life. We have to guard your heart. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, I have to guard my heart. I got to watch even what you say. You might be sitting next to me saying something, but I got to guard my heart that I don't get no anger in my heart. I don't get no malice in my heart. I don't get no jealousy in my heart. I don't get no hard feelings, that I'm not offended because of something you say. I realize if you say something to offend me, well, God, you're still working on them like you're working on me. You're working on them just like you're working on me. See, our mind with the Holy Spirit assists us, can control the compulsions of our carnal mindset from influencing our actions. With the Holy Spirit working through it, the Bible tells in Galatians, the 5th chapter, the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such is no law. So what are the effects of having temperance? God, I want to focus on that word temperance as a major component of our spirit. Temperance speaks of our self-control. Temperance, self-control. Temperance, our self-control, would enable us to fight the attacks troubling our mind because we are responding to the law of the word, not the law of our sinful nature. The Bible tells us in Romans, the 8th chapter, through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life has set me free from the law of sin and death. So I am free. Say, I'm free. Hallelujah. Temperance, our self-control, subdue our mind to obey our inner spirit under the influence of Holy Spirit. That's what it does. That's what temperance does. Proverbs, the 16th chapter, it says, it is better to be slow-tempered than famous. It is better to have self-control than control of an army. In other words, self-control. You might feel yourself urging, being, you know, feeling a need to say something. Self-control say, no, I'm not going to say that. I'm going to keep my mouth shut. I'm just going to walk on. I'm going to go into and get in the place by myself so I don't lose control. And the more that you keep control, the more that you're going to be able to maintain control over self. Self-control. Self-control will keep us in the attack mode against deception, and we will not make radical decisions that are emotionally driven when we have self-control. Ephesians, the 4th chapter, verse 27 says, Do not give the devil a foothold. Don't let him think that he's in control. Don't give him any idea. See, he doesn't know what was said or what was done affected you until he see you acting out of control. He said, so now I got something to work with. I got something to work with. Self-control is liberating to our spirit, man. See, we have been empowered with Holy Spirit to subdue the old way of thinking. Hallelujah. I want you to say that out of your mouth. I've been empowered with the Holy Spirit to subdue my old way of thinking. See, and the forces attacking our mind has no defense because of our self-control. The thought's going to come, but it can't break through because of my self-control. And if we control ourselves emotionally, it will keep a check in our thinking. In other words, if I'm controlled, then when that thought comes, say, oh, no, grab that thought. I'm not going to be like that. I'm not going to do that. Grab that thought. Throw that one over there. Amen. And so it keeps a check in our thinking. Then we can war off the spiritual attacks with God's word. You can war off the spiritual attacks when you have God's word and you have self-control. Because self-control is a wall of defense that protects us, watch this, from ourselves. From ourselves. I got to protect me from me. Hallelujah. A lot of times when I'm saying, thinking, I think I'm saying it in the right spirit, but I'm actually, you get that high pitch. You say, No. You're about to lose control. Now, to somebody else, it's like, okay, you're upset. To you, it sounds like, well, no, I'm not upset. No, that high pitch came on your, and you had that high pitch to come in, you tune it up. See? So that's why we have to learn to fight through the forces attacking our mind. We have to fight through them. Fight through the forces attacking our mind. no matter no matter what happened, we got to be in control of what's happening. And in conclusion, brothers and sisters, I want you to know this. We cannot be out of control and walk in victory. You can't be out of control and walk in victory at the same time. Therefore, self-control is an action of submission, application, and faith in God's word. We got to determine the outcome of the fight. And how do we do that? By simply the implication of the word and not allowing Satan to control how we think. Praise God. We can't allow him to control how we think. And so we're going to fight through. We're going to fight through. We've made up our mind. We're going to fight through. I want you to say this out loud. It says, I'm going to fight through the forces that has attacked in my mind. And I'm walking in victory each and every day. I will not respond to every thought that comes to my mind. I will not allow my emotions to have the best of me. I am victorious because of the word of God. I am victorious because of Holy Spirit. I allow Holy Spirit to lead me, to guide me, to instruct me, to inform me, to assist me in Jesus' name. Praise God. And if you really believe that, hallelujah, give God a praise while you're looking at the screen right now. Give him a praise. He will lead you and he will guide you and he will direct you in what you need to do. Praise God. Fight through the forces attacking your mind. Fight through it. Praise God. And learn how to be submissive to God's word. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for those that are listening on and everything, Lord, that we have taught today that you brought to heart to their spirit. I pray that they grab hold of it. In the name of Jesus. Fight, fight, and fight some more. Fight through the forces. Attack it. Our mind. We have to know how to fight. We can't do this on our own. We need Holy Spirit. We need Lord God to be submissive. We need, Father, to apply your word. And we need to have faith in your word that we can win the battle. No matter what's coming and what is happening, we declare that we have the victory that is in Christ Jesus. We trust you for that today. In Jesus' name. Amen. If you're out there right now and you're dealing with thoughts that's been rushing through your mind, thoughts that's been coming, and you've been trying to fight against those thoughts, I just want to come in agreement with you here this morning. I want you to put your hand right on your head, just like this here. In the name of Jesus, I command that those thoughts that are rushing through your mind, thoughts that is contrary to that which God has declared in his word, that a peace come on your mind. Hallelujah. I want you just to wipe it off right now, just like you're wiping it away. And from this day forth, you will take on, hallelujah. I want you to say it out loud with your mouth. I have the mind of Christ. I think like Christ thinks. I have his mind. I will be obedient to God's word in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. If you don't know Christ as your personal Savior, I'm going to give you the opportunity for you to come to know him. It's so important that you might know Christ as your Lord and Savior. The Bible declares that if we confess with our mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe that God raised him from the dead, we will be saved. For with the heart man believe unto salvation and confession. For heart man believe unto righteousness and confession unto salvation. And so God wants to save you because he loves you. And all you have to do is just repeat this little simple prayer after me. Lord Jesus, you died for my sins. Forgive me of all of my sin. Come into my heart. I receive you today as my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Lord, for saving me and washing me in the blood of Jesus. Fill me with Holy Spirit that I might live for you all the remaining days of my life. If you prayed that a simple prayer, we believe that by faith that you are right now saved, that you are saved right now according to God's word. I'm going to ask if you don't mind, why don't you call somebody? It can be a friend, a loved one, a family member, and let them know, I got saved today. I gave my life to Jesus. And then why don't you email us at jplifecc@cox.net, or you can write us a letter at Jesus People, Life Changing Church, 800 Northwest 39th Avenue. Praise God. Just to let us know that that you receive Christ as your Lord and Savior. Well, God bless you. We'll see you on Tuesday night. And always remember these words, that Christ can change your life, but only you can change your destiny. God bless.
Amen. We praise God for the word. Hallelujah. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord, for you have no reason to fear. The Lord is with you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to your name, Jesus. We celebrate you. Come on, just right where you are. Thank God for the word. Fight, 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 and fight some more. Hey. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Tell me who has the final say.
Jehovah has the final say.
Tell me who has the final say.
Jehovah has the final say.
No matter what the doctor says,
Jehovah has the final say.
No matter what my money says,
Jehovah has the final say.
I have
no reason to fear.
Yeah.
I have no reason to fear.
Why? Because the Lord.
The Lord is my life.
Yes, he is. He's my life.
The Lord is my life.
Yeah. I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Thank you, Lord.
I have no reason.
The Lord is.
The Lord is my life.
Yes, he is. The Lord is.
The Lord is my life.
Come on, celebrate out there. Hallelujah. Tell me who has the final say.
Jehovah has.
Yes,
the final say.
Tell me who has the final say. Yeah.
Jehovah.
He has the final say. Thank you, Lord. No matter what the doctor says, you are healed.
Jehovah has the final say.
Hallelujah. No matter what the lawyer says,
Jehovah has the final say. I have no reason to fear.
Come on, you have no reason to fear.
I have no reason to fear.
Why? Because the Lord is.
The Lord is my life.
Yes, he is. He's my light.
The Lord is my light.
Yeah. Come on, say, I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Come on, sing it in your house.
Declare. I have no reason to
fear. The Lord is.
The Lord is my light.
Yes, he is. The Lord is.
The Lord is my light.
Come on, when the Lord is your light, you have no reason to fear. Come on, you can shine bright. Shine like a diamond that you are. You are a jewel. Hallelujah. Come on, begin to praise him. Begin to glorify him. Hey, I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Come on, you can dance because you are victorious.
I have no reason.
Come on, begin to move around in your house. Begin to thank God.
I have no
for the word.
To
hallelujah.
Fear.
Come on, begin to celebrate
no
him. Hallelujah. I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Yay. Come on, we have the great one with us. I have
no reason to fear.
Come on, I feel a shout on that. Come on, you can dance because you have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Come on, hey. Begin to shout right there in your house. I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
Come on, celebrate. Celebrate them. I have
no reason to fear.
I have no reason.
I have no reason to fear.
I have no reason to fear.
I have no reason to fear.
The Lord is with me.
I have no reason to fear.
He's on my side.
I have no reason to fear.
He said I never leave you.
I have no reason to fear.
Nor forsake you.
I have no reason to fear.
I have no reason to fear.
I have no reason.
your side. The Lord is
my light.
Yes, he is. One more time. The Lord is my light. Yes, God.
The Lord is my light.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.